It's been a hell of a 12 months. Looking back to last March, I had this tree come down on my utility pole, got it all cleaned up, but it did cost me quite a bit of money for a new pole. But I was able to get out metal detecting.
Alright, it's March, and the ground's still froze. We still got snow here and there. Got more snow coming tomorrow, so I won't be out here doing this. It's a Noka impact, and we got our first target. We'll see what we got here. All right, we were getting a mid-tone out of this hole here. Comes this piece of lead. I'm not quite sure what it went to. It's got a hole in it, see? Or something, I don't know. No idea on that one. So nice out here in the field. And we got a couple more finds for you. A couple mid-tones again. A little piece of bullet. One bullet and one ear tag. From livestock, obviously. Never know what you're going to find in these old fields. For another day. It's a little cloudier today, but the ground is thawed. And our first decent find of the day. Been digging a lot of lead out here in this field. There's a spoon bowl. It's down there pretty good. Let's see if we can get something else. If we can, we'll blame it on Carol Baskins. Got one ringing pretty high here. And when we go to deep mode, numbers a little different. 84. Maybe it's a large copper. I think it's a little larger than that. All right, we'll dig her up, find out. Well, unfortunately, I had to dig through this chisel through this frozen ground for this aluminium. I had something really good, and this ground is froze. I had to chisel it out. I had that showing. I had to dig around it a little bit because I didn't want to hurt it, whatever it was. One of those minor tags, or that's what that is. I don't get many of those around here, but that's the third one I've gotten out of this field. Well, not all of us are hibernating in our houses. I got this big field out behind my house, a big old farm that I can hunt during our quarantine. And I got the Noka impact with the hunter coil, and I got my first find. All right, out of that hole there, it rang up nice. It's this big piece of brass off something. Good for recycling. High 40s, low 50s. We'll dig that up, see what it is. Alright, been in this back corner, getting near the snow. The ground's getting a little froze here. And I got me part of a proper relic. Little piece of a curdle bell sitting there. Right in the frozen mud. Alright, I hope you enjoyed those clips from last March. That was when I was able to get out digging for the first time in 2020. Just remembering back to the beginning of the pandemic and all the lockdowns and all that good stuff. I got something a little different for you now. I wrote a little story for American Digger magazine, but they never published it. They weren't interested in it, probably because it was fictional. I hope you enjoy it. It's going to be narrated by the AI of my Microsoft program. So have a listen. I hope you enjoy.
A metal detecting story. Two metal detecting buddies arrive at an old New England farm field. Rock walls separate the property from the neighboring fields. There is a pleasant aroma of fresh-cut hay and a picturesque setting sun. The experience and equipment of the men were even, giving each an equal chance to score treasure this evening. Wearing long pants and flannel shirts to fight off the crisp early autumn air, they turned on their metal detectors and proceeded up into the field. Digger 1 is a disciplined master of gritting. In his mind, it is the best method for success. Using the imprints left by the hay cut as a guide, he begins to grid. Determined not to miss a signal, he swings his detector low and slow, overlapped each pass carefully. We will call him the gridder. The second digger is more of a free spirit. He heads to the hilltop in the middle of the field for no apparent reason. In his mind, that looks like a good place to detect. Determined to make the most of the remaining daylight, he briskly swings his detector back and forth toward the horizon. He is not too concerned with overlapping his swings or what he might pass by en route to his spot. Gritting to him is a tedious and boring method of detecting. We shall refer to him as the wanderer. The gritter, staying disciplined, walks row after row as he drags his shovel on the grass behind him to mark his grid. Through his headphones, he hears the wanderer's machine in the distance. He has become accustomed to the sounds of his hunting partner's machine, because the wanderer does not use headphones. Ignoring the sounds of his friend's metal detector, the gritter continues his grid and comes across a strong, repeatable high tone. His heart rate rises as he anticipates a large copper or silver coin. The target is deeper than expected, and the rocky ground was difficult to dig. After a few minutes, he uses his pinpointer to uncover an ox shoe that was 10 inches down. That was not what he was hoping for, but he was not too disappointed to dig a proper New England relic. Once he carefully fills in the hole and packs down the plug, he looks for his friend. To his surprise, his friend has left the hilltop and wandered to the north side of the field, just barely in view. How did he cover so much ground so quickly? He thought to himself as he continued detecting. The wanderer has found a patch of iron and is trying to pick out a decent tone. His machine sounds off on all the iron before an iffy high tone emerges. Digging deep, he is thrilled to uncover a complete crotal bell. Bells are his favorite relics to dig. When rescanning the hole, another high tone rings out. This time it's an Indian head penny. He filled his hole and continued to detect directionless across the field. Meanwhile, the gritter's grid is expanding as he completes row after row. This area of the field is very quiet, with very little action. In his mind, it's just a matter of time before his gritting method pays off. Staying disciplined, he completes another long row and looks around for his friend again. He spots the wanderer on the south end of the field. How does that fool ever find anything? He whispered to himself. The sun is now barely visible over the distant pine trees as the two detectorists continue their quest for treasure. The gritter, with little luck so far, works another row as he spots his friend up ahead crossing the row he is working. He feels violated, but keeps his cool. Can't he see that he is in my path? He thinks to himself. The gritter yells out to his friend, "Any luck?" The wanderer turns and approaches, and as he nears, he pulls out of his pouch the crotal bell, 2 wheat cents, and the Indian. The gritter shakes his head as he pulls the ox shoe and 2 clad dimes from his pouch. You are killing me, we only have another 45 minutes or so of daylight, you know. Each turned and continued on their way as before. The gritter, becoming weary from the lack of production of his method, has thoughts of aborting and wandering like his friend. He ignores the urge and continues to grid. His friend yells bingo from across the field. It's a large cent, the wanderer shouts. The gritter is now pissed. His disciplined approach has failed him. After scanning row after row, he abandons his grid and starts wandering the field aimlessly like his friend. He comes across evidence of plugs dug by his friend, so he heads in a different part of the field. Again he comes across other filled plugs and thinks to himself, am I just repeating in my friend's footsteps? The wanderer smiles when he notices that his friend has abandoned grinning. He has a solid mid-tone on his machine and digs a military eagle button. The two men orbit the field for another half hour as the daylight fades. They cross paths again, and this time the gritter has a nice find. He has an old Tootsie toy truck to show his friend this time. They compare finds before they spot a familiar truck pulling into the field. They look at each other and shake their heads. Here he comes again, says the gritter. It's about time, the wanderer replies. The third hunter arriving late as usual hardly knows his machine. Digging only the high tones he likes to cherry pick what he digs. His friends try to help him learn, but this guy thinks he has got it all figured out. If you have not guessed yet, this is that guy. You know, that guy, the guy who detects a massive field, and walks directly to and digs the best find in the middle of that field. Surely you have met that guy before. You know the guy who finds everything with his magical detector. We will refer to him as Lucky. Lucky is full of vigor and marches up into the field. He starts swinging his detector fast and nowhere near the ground. He spots his two friends in the field and salutes them by waving his detector in the air. Knowing that darkness is approaching fast, he avoids socializing and continues. The wanderer and gritter continue metal detecting too. The gritter looks over toward his grid area and sees Lucky digging a target. A few minutes pass, and he notices Lucky still digging in what appears to be the same hole. He thinks nothing of it, as he could be digging a deeply buried ox shoe, he thinks to himself. Next time he looks over, the wanderer and Lucky are both digging near his abandoned grid. Now he is becoming curious and starts detecting in that direction. As he approached, he noticed they were comparing finds, which is a dead giveaway that something good was dug. Noticing that the gritter was approaching, the other two waved him over. The closer he got, he could hear the joy and laughter of the other two. His blood was starting to boil as he could see that they were standing just beyond his grid. The lines left by dragging his shovel stopped 10 feet or so before Lucky's hole. Keeping his composure, he asked calmly, "All right, what have you guys found?" The wanderer replied, "I got another large scent right over there," pointing to an area very close to his grid. Lucky, standing over an uncovered hole, replied, "I found the mother lode. I got a high tone and dug this seated quarter, and there was more in the hole. Next, I pulled out a barber dime, and then a seated dime. My pinpointer would not stop, I got two Indians, and then this." He reached out and opened his hand, revealing a stunning seated dollar. It was the most beautiful silver coin that the gritter had ever seen. Now his blood was beyond boiling, and steam whistles were going off out of his ears. "Congratulations," he said in a sarcastic voice. "Ask yourself, are you the gritter? Do you orbit like the wanderer? Or do you feel that you are lucky punk?" The end.